Welcome to all of you on my channel. This is Samiruddin and this is seventh video of our Java programming tutorial. Firstly, I would like to request to all of you, please like and subscribe my channel. In our previous videos, we have discussed about contains, Java overview, versions, features of Java, some basic structures of Java, OOP concept, data types, keywords, JVM, JRE, JDK, and compilation process. Now I am going to compare object-oriented programming concept and procedure-oriented programming concept using some parameters. In this video, I will also discuss some advantages of object-oriented programming concept over procedure-oriented programming concept. So let's discuss difference between programming procedure-oriented programming concept and object-oriented programming concept point-wise. So first of all, according to structure. In procedure-oriented programming, are divided into small self-contained functions. While in object-oriented programming concept, the programs are divided into small entities called object. Object is a real-world entity, as we discussed earlier in previous videos. While function can perform any task like for addition, for subtraction, for multiplication and division, we can create a particular function for performing a specific task. So procedure-oriented programming is a function-based programming concept, while object-oriented programming concept is a object-based programming concept. Next is, here you can see an example: main statement, then function 1, function 2, function up to n, same as object up to n. Next is focus. In procedure-oriented programming concept, not focused only data, but it focused to functions as well as sequence of action or procedure or steps to be done on that function. While in object-oriented programming concept, only focus on data rather than that procedure or steps, because object-oriented programming concept works on real world. Next is axis specifier. So procedure-oriented programming concept doesn't contain any axis specifier, but in case of object-oriented programming concept, it contains axis specifier like public, private and protected. Public specifier access data anywhere and use data publicly, and by private specifier we can only access those data which present inside same class or object. That means it only accesses internal content. And next is protected. Protected means, suppose in Java program a superclass and a subclass are present, so only data can access when subclass inherited through superclass and data becomes protected. Next one is data transfer or data moving. In procedure oriented programming concept, data can easily move from function to function, while in object oriented programming concept, data cannot move, but only object can transfer data through communication with objects to each other by calling member function. So next one is very important and main point, that is approach. Procedure oriented programming follows top down approach, while object oriented programming follows bottom up approach. So what is top down approach and what is bottom up approach? I will give more explanation about this topic separately, but in this video we can give you a little explanation. So we can take an example to understand top down approach and bottom up approach. Suppose in an university, HOD, that is head of department, can make some decision about management of university, and HOD can process instruction to the faculty. Here you can see HOD take a decision and instruct it to the faculty members, and faculty can process that instruction after implementing to the student. Then faculty give the instruction after implementing to the students. So in this example, we can notice instruction started from top to bottom. Here you can see instruction started from HOD, then faculty, then student. That means top to bottom. Why? But in case of object oriented programming concept, student can give some suggestion about university. Here you can see student can make a decision or give some suggestion about university and passes to head of department, HOD, through faculty members. Then HOD can research about that situation or problem. Then HOD can take final decision. In this approach, we can see suggestions started from the students, then it passes through faculty, and faculty passes to the HOD. So these are all about top-down approach and bottom-up approach. After that, next point is updation. In procedure-oriented programming, it is difficult to add new data and new functions, while in object-oriented programming, we can easily add new data and functions. Next one is data access. In procedure-oriented programming, maximum function uses global data. That means a data can declare outside main function, and that data used by more than one function, that is global data. While in case of object oriented, nothing is global. This concept is not applicable on object oriented programming, but only we can control data. In object oriented programming concept, we can only control data through public or private keywords. Next one is data hiding. in the procedure oriented programming is less secure because there is no way of data hiding in POP, which is the concept of data abstraction and encapsulation. Also, I hope everybody knows C programming, which follows procedure oriented programming concept, in which a traditional pointer concept present, by which we can able to access any data from anywhere by giving some reference address through pointer. But in case of object oriented programming, we can able to hiding data through encapsulation. So it is because it is more secure than procedure oriented programming concept. So let's move on next topic, that is overloading. Overloading is not possible in procedure oriented programming concept, while overloading is possible in object oriented programming concept by the help of polymorphism concept. After that, we can take some examples. Like in OOP, here you can see some example: C programming, Visual Basic, Fortran, Pascal, etc. While in case of object oriented programming, here you can see C++, Java, VB.NET, C#, etc. Comparisons of procedure oriented programming and object oriented programming concept. In next video, I will discuss some more concept about Java programming. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thank you for watching. Good luck. Goodbye.